इंदिरा गांधी नेशनल ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी प्रेजेंट्स ए प्रोग्राम फॉर डिप्लोमा इन इवेंट मैनेजमेंट इंटाइटल्ड सर्चिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर इवेंट मैनेजमेंट बिजनेस कोर्स 1 BHC 011. पार्टिसिपेंट्स आर अंकुर कालरा, विपुल पांधी एंड डॉक्टर हीना के बिजली. लेट्स लिसन द प्रोग्राम सर्चिंग अपॉर्चुनिटीज फॉर इवेंट मैनेजमेंट.
Event management is one area that has the requisite synergy to attract job opportunities for the youth and increase employability. It is my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Ankur Kalra, the founder and CEO of Vibigor Brand Services, one of India's leading experiential marketing and brand activation companies. It is an honor to have with us another eminent expert, Mr. Vipul Pandhi. Vipul is the founder director of Workaholics Event Solutions Private Limited. Mr. Ankur, I would like to start with you. Could you please tell our learners about the different categories of events in the event industry today?
First of all, thank you so much for having us here. It's a pleasure to be part of this great project that IGNU has taken up. As far as events is concerned, I would think there are largely six categories that fall into the scope of event management. The first one, and in my opinion, one of the most important ones, is corporate events which are done by companies to promote their product or their service or to launch a new product. The second is brand activation, where we reach out to consumers through using events as a tool in order to promote the products or services or introduce them to a consumer or sample them to a consumer. The third is called MICE, which is meeting, incentives, conferences and expositions. The fourth is sports events. The fifth is conferences on any serious sector. And the sixth and the final is the social events category, which includes weddings, birthday parties, anniversary events, any kind of a social event. So in my opinion, these are the six key categories that are there in the event management industry today.
Mr. Vipul, would you like to say something about the career directions in event management today? And what are some of the entry barriers for people who would want to work in the event industry?
Okay, I'll answer the questions one by one. First, we are talking about the career directions. See, people who think that, you know, they are creative, they can come out with innovative ideas. People who think, who can understand what brand stands for, how the brand can communicate with the audience. So I think this is one area where people strengths in communication and brand understanding can excel. Besides that, the backbone of any event agency is the operations and the planning team. So people who are good in operations, in planning, in execution strategies, they can also come forward and be a part of it. Besides these two domains, event management also attracts talent from the field of creatives, people who design in 2D and 3D, you know, who help us visualize how the event will look like, and the ancillary support services like finance and admin. So I think these are the four main domains where they can come on board and contribute.
If I can add, Vipul, there are three key parts. The first part is people who get in the business, which is what, like Vipul said. The second part is people who plan the business, add value to the business, which is the creative people, the copywriters, the designers. And the third part is the people who execute business. It's almost like Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. People who get the life, people who plan the life, and people who execute it. So these are the three main trinity of our industry, which is people who get in the business, people who think about the business, and people who execute the business. Other than that, like any other industry, we've got admin, we've got finance, we've got HR, we've got IT, all the ancillary services. But the three main sectors which add value to event management are these three, like Vipul had said correctly.
Ankur, would you just tell us something about the entry barriers which individuals face if they want to work in an event industry and event company?
See, I think people who need to work in an event company, they have to be very spontaneous. They have to have the ability to think on their feet. They have to have the ability to take quick decisions and convert them into action. So that, if you don't have that ability, then you're not cut out for the event management industry. The biggest entry barrier is the ability to be able to think and take quick actions.
Vipul, would you like to add to something to that?
Yeah, see, we meet up as an association and see, you know, what are the barriers, how we can take things forward. To me, the biggest barrier is a client. There, you have to have a client who has faith in your abilities that you can add value to his event. So if you have a client who has abilities, could be your parents for some siblings' wedding in the family, could be your friends for their birthday parties. So you must have someone who have abilities in your thinking, in your innovation, your creativity, and bingo, you are an event manager.
Mr. Ankur, I'd like to ask you another pertinent question. Coming from the brand activation part of event industry, what entrepreneurial skills would you suggest to our learners who want to start an event management company on their own, knowing that you yourself are a success story and have founded your own company?
The first and most important skill is to be able to think spontaneously, to be able to act spontaneously. The second is always have faith in yourself. No project is so big that you can't do it. Everybody who has conviction in their abilities is fit to be an entrepreneur in event management and an entrepreneur anywhere. The third is to keep abreast with the latest technologies. It's very important. The world of technology is changing so fast, right from social media to various new technologies which are coming in every day. If you're abreast with the latest technologies, you're equipped to be an entrepreneur. And the last and the most important is to be able to take risks. If you don't have the ability to take risks, then you cannot be an entrepreneur in the event management business. So these are the four main things. Have faith in yourself, keep abreast with the latest technologies, think on your feet, and of course to take risks.
Vipul, you're a successful entrepreneur yourself. Would you like to tell our learners about certain entrepreneurial skills while you were setting up your event company?
We are in a business of selling dreams, selling experiences. So in order to successfully weave together such experiences, it's very important that we go in depth as to what our client wants, what a brand stands for, what is that they would like to communicate. So one has to do a thorough research as to what the client requires.
So customer needs,
of course, you're talking about. I think if you were to be a successful customer, you must do your homework as to what your client will buy, how he will benefit. So a research is one area I would like to highlight. Secondly, I would like to say that, you know, you must have exposure in various domains, because getting a business is easy. Thinking of ideas for someone is easy. Doing an event for someone is easy. But if you're an entrepreneur, you have to have command on all the domains that event management stands for. So get relevant exposure to all the areas before you think of becoming an entrepreneur. And I think working with some good respected companies in this field and gaining experience with such brands will be helpful for people who want to become an entrepreneur later in life.
Mr. Vipul, the opportunity assessment process starts with a bidding proposal for the event. Could you tell us something about this process, the RFQs?
See, RFQs is just a part of the analyzing opportunity. RFQs are usually used by big corporates who have a systems in place, who have a commercial team in place, and that's how they are the ones who've coined this term. But if it's assessment only, you have to be open to business opportunities around. Now, as far as RFQ is concerned, these are typical formats in which corporate states their requirement in a very standardized way, so that the same can be shared with other event companies or event managers as well.
What is the full form of RFQ?
It's request for quotation. There are two terms, RFP and RFQ, request for proposal and request for quotation. Like Vipul said, it is standardization of their requirement. If they brief five agencies, they get five different ideas. But in order to get costs in a standardized manner so that they can compare five different agencies, they create a standard format which needs to be filled in, which is called a request for quotation or a request for proposal. So the same form is given, the same Excel sheet is given to five agencies, and they are expected to fill it in the same format without changing the format, so that they can very easily compare the cost from A agency to B agency.
How does an event organizer decide which business opportunity is right? I mean, how does one do environmental scanning? What are those opportunity assessment parameters in terms of programs, markets, and finances which give better return on investment?
See, the biggest parameter is, of course, margin. What is the amount of profit that is being made from a particular event? But there are various other parameters. The first and the foremost being, what is the future value of that particular client or that particular business? So if I believe that I'm doing a business of 5 lakhs with Hindustan Lever, but they are potentially a 1 crore client for me per year, then I give it huge importance. And even if I'm not making too much margin in that first event, I make sure that all my efforts are done to develop that into a long-term client. So the long-term thinking is one of the most important parameters. The second is, today is the age of IPs, intellectual properties. So there are various events which we have to invest in for the first year or two, but we realize that after a period of time, they can turn into huge properties which can yield us very good returns. Examples being Sunburn or IFA. So they started small, but today they are at such a stage where they are huge money earners for the companies that run them. So it is the client, it is the longevity of the event, and it is the stickiness to the target audience. So if I do an event for kids with, say, a popular character like Chota Bheem, it will have a huge attraction for the kids, and I will be able to easily sell that to a sponsor. So these are the 2-3 factors that one thinks of while deciding on where should one concentrate one's energies.
Mr. Vipul, could you please tell us about the scope of event management in terms of the way the event and activation industry is growing today?
Scope usually only talks about the growth one gets monetarily and the stability that one gets. But I would like to highlight here that in event management, the scope is not only the money that you earn, but also the kind of personality you develop. We often are faced challenges by doing something new every day. So once we are doing an event in Mumbai, then maybe in Tibet, then doing an activity in Bihar. So this gives us tremendous exposure to various cultures and geographies. I will say not only in India, but across the world. So as a personality, you grow a lot. You are a smart thinker. You are able to source things for your personal use as well. You are able to build up relationships and, you know, get your job done, be it your society watchman or your maid or your client. You know how to handle people. So this is one part that I would like to highlight. Now going to the growth, as far as the monies are concerned, it can start from a basic salary of 5-10,000 rupees to maybe a salary of say 10 lakh rupees a month as well. So people, you know, organizations, they value what the person is able to bring to the table, you know, what they are able to contribute to the organization. And if you are able to contribute well, then I will say sky is the limit.
The latest study on the event and activation industry reveals that there are organized and unorganized players. Could you just tell our learners about this?
Sure. Like I told you in the first question, a large part of our business is social events. This represents most of the unorganized part of the industry, which means that where transactions are not properly revealed. Because whenever we do weddings and social events in our country, it is a custom that the total amounts are never revealed for various reasons, legal and social and other reasons. First of all, if I'd like to address your previous question, the scope is huge in the event management industry. As per a study jointly done by EMA and Ernst & Young, we are growing at an annual rate of 26%, which is more than any other media or industry that, you know, whether it's TV or radio or holdings, all of them are growing in the range of 5-15%. So we are growing, the event management or the experiential marketing industry is growing at 26% annually and is expected to grow at the same rate over the next 5-6 years. I think this is a sunrise sector. I can't think of any other in an associated field which is growing at that rate. Now coming to the organized and disorganized sector, I estimate 30-40% of the revenues of our industry are from the disorganized sector. So if Ernst & Young estimates our industry at 5-6,000 crores, I would say the total size of the industry is 10,000 crores. And out of that, 5-6,000 crores is organized and 4-5,000 crores is disorganized. That is the sector, you know, whatever the market situation is, whatever the dollar rate is, people don't stop doing weddings in our country. People don't stop celebrating birthdays and anniversaries in our country. People don't stop organizing their children's parties in our country. So that is a huge segment which is called the disorganized or unorganized segment, which is difficult to count and which is difficult to estimate. But Ernst & Young in their study has revealed that about 40% of the total industry is disorganized, and that will also grow at a tremendous rate, whatever the market situation be.
Ankur and Vipul, you've been a part of the association called EMA. You still are. You play a major role in the dynamics of EMA. Could you just tell us about EMA?
EMA was formed in 2008 when a handful of event managers, including Vipul, me and a few others from Delhi, realized that we are not known as an industry and there are various benefits which could happen by getting together. We 5-7 of us event managers got together and we planted the seed of EMA, and today it's grown to about 120 top event management companies, and this consists of about 70% of the total amount that is transacted in the event management industry is done by EMA members. Some of our key contributions include representing this as an industry to the government, asking for tax benefits, fighting cases with various players who we feel are detrimental to this industry, creating educational courses that further the cause of this industry, getting together and forming HR practices, and a feeling of camaraderie and learning from each other. So these are some of the key things that EMA does, and it's a growing institution, and today we've got applications coming in every day, but we only take the people who are serious about this industry and who we feel have it in them to bring value to the industry.
As successful event managers of our country today, you also have a global presence. Both of you, Ankur and Vipul, what would you advise to our learners? Suggest to them certain areas which would be really motivational for them to take up event management as a profession in the future?
If you are a keen learner, if you want to continue learning every day, then you need to be in event management. Every day, the beauty of my job is that every day it's a new job. That is what the beauty of event management is. I don't do the same thing ever again. Every day I come to office and I have a new job, I have a new career. And if you want to continue growing, if you want to continue learning, then this is the place to be.
Vipul?
When I started my career, IT industry was dominating the space in India. A lot of people were getting IT courses and, you know, jobs in BPOs. And I either had an option of an IT industry wherein I would be sitting in my office the whole day and working on computer doing something. And other option was the normal sales, you know, team where I'll be going out and selling things to people around. So I didn't want it to sit the whole day in office. I didn't want it to be out the whole day. And I think I was lucky enough to get into this profession because this gives me the best of both worlds. I can sit in my office, I can strategize, I can think of ideas on big brands. On the same hand, I go and I meet the top leaders of the industry. So we get to meet a lot of, you know, people who are influencers of industry in political scenario. So I think this is one thing I loved about it. And this is something which I always wanted to have best of both worlds. So this gives me best of both worlds. Secondly, I would like to add that whenever you do a successful event, right from the day you bag it, you know, when you are competing with 2-3 people and eventually client gives you the mandate to go ahead and deliver, to the final day when the event happens and you execute it. So there is a different high altogether. It gives you a high of a winner because you are standing and you see thousands of people having a good time just because you planned it well. So people are coming, dancing, enjoying, but they don't know that you are the people who've put that together. So that high makes us going. You know, that high of achieving something day in and day out, achiever, and high of making people happy, I think that is something which gets us going.
Ankur and Vipul, we know that you are an inspiration for our learners, and we hope that every learner out there will carry out his task with the same enthusiasm and guts that you have done. Thank you, Ankur and Vipul.
Thank you for having us here.
You were listening to the program Searching Opportunities for Event Management Business. Participants were Ankur Kalra, Vipul Pandhi, and Dr. Hina K. Bijli. Content Coordinator, Dr. Hina K. Bijli. Recording, Zainuddin and Archana. Announcement, Aarti Karihallu. Editing, Sadhan Lal. Producer, Dinesh Devakar. This program was brought to you by Electronic Media Production Center of Indira Gandhi National Open University.